thank you. We are just off I-95 at the home of the Eagles, Lincoln Financial Field, on the south side of Philadelphia. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago. Boy, the city of brotherly love is fired up. They're saying fly, Eagles, fly, as they get ready to match up with Matt Ryan and the Atlanta Falcons. Connection here with Nelson Agholor. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. I think defensively you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on. And I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up a third down.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action and hit them over the top.
They'll try and pick it up by running the option to the right. He may try and run for this. Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a fourth down. So on fourth down, here's the veteran left-footed punter Donnie Jones to kick it away. Back deep here, Andre Roberts. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. And this is taken at the 23. It'll be a 44-yard punt, 6 on the return. And the Falcons will be taking over first and 10. And here now come the Falcons. Play fake here on first down. This one complete to Mohamed Sanu. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A good pickup there, a 22.
Partner, this is one of the best routes anyone can have in their offensive playbook. Tough to defend because you think it's a go route, and then he breaks it back on the comeback. There's one other thing you need as well.
A well-thrown ball.
Exactly right. Got a guy who has some precision in throwing the football because of the timing of the route.
On first down, Ryan. He lost 9 there. That's really going to set him back for second down. Freeman, and he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. He had a great read there from his free safety position. And Charles, you know, with those guys, it's all about their eyes. They have to be laser focused.
Yeah, I had to fake my way through it when I was playing, but now I can see exactly what they're doing. And on that play, he obviously had no presence to feel like he's being pushed for a pass, and without that, that allowed him to get up to the line of scrimmage and hold him to no gain.
Third and long, it's Ryan. He completes it to Julio Jones. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. They'll wind up with 17 on that one, but they're still a bit short here for fourth.
I don't care who you put on him, he's going to be a handful in one-on-one throws.
Yeah, right now, you're right. They're in man-to-man, maybe need some safety help.
I would say that'd be a good idea. Double-team him somehow. I'm going to have to make someone else beat me rather than let him shred my defense.
And this one is no good. He missed it. And this will remain a scoreless game.
Every
everything look good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
Two sides to every coin. This is the bad side of missing the 58-yarder. Now they start at the 48. Here's a handoff to Ajayi to begin the drive. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Well, they know how to protect the pass, but sometimes cornerbacks, they can also stop the run, can't they?
Is that what we call a complete corner? Yeah, because we're so used to these guys just being defenders in the pass game. How about the guys who can come up and make the tackles? That's what we just saw there for no gain, too.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
So a third and 10, and defensively, a dime look, six DBs. Here's Foles. It's complete, left side to Aguilar. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first. 46 on his first kick. This one in that neighborhood as well. And this one hits at the one, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. Atlanta now coming out on the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer
this time?
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
As if he didn't have enough to think about on that route, the comeback route, coming back to the football and catching it, started to make sure he toe-tapped and kept himself in bounds.
And that was spectacular, but on the comeback route, maybe a little easier to deal with the sideline since you've got better vision of it.
I think that's a great point because you should know exactly where you're going and know how much space you have and make sure you get your feet down. But, yeah, coming back to the football, I like it. Good vision. Well, after what we just saw, we know that with third down coming up, this is not a gimme for the offense. They've got to figure out what they want to do. Do they challenge their offensive line and try and run it? Or do they go ahead and concede that this is a tough defense and put it in the air?
Off the play fake to Freeman. It's Ryan. And it's complete. Hooper. A Falcon first down. Ryan to his young tight end, Hooper.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? And it sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. Now Ryan on first down. It's caught over the middle, Hooper. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50.
Now, that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. Second down now after the pass completion. They'll run it now out of the gun. And some space here. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only the controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. Gets it off to Freeman. Give him six on the play, and that'll bring up second down. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well.
I think of Tevin Coleman as a really good combo back. He can run it, but in terms of being a third down back, I think he ranks with the best in the league.
So good at leaking out of the backfield. Ryan finding him there for the Falcons first. The former Indiana Hoosier here, Tevin Coleman. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
But they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you've got to continue to try and run and try and keep a defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Back to the ground, this time with Freeman. Yeah, and he's able to get most of what he needed on the carry there. 7 yards on the gain, and it's third and two now.
Getting had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Play number nine set to come here on the drive on third and two. They'll run it now out of the gun. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down. And when you're running the football, one thing you don't want to see is a big boy coming up there to swallow you whole in those D tackles and nose tackles.
No, you're actually counting on your big boys to protect you from them. But on that play, the defensive tackle had the leverage, and he won the battle. No gain, correct?
No gain. And the 42-year-old veteran's kick is up and good. And the Falcons are out to a 3-0 advantage. And that field goal caps an 11-play drive.
That's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points, but they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
Here's Bosher to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. This is their third drive. Right now, maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't gotten a first down yet in this game.
It's a mental barrier you don't think about until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. Then all of a sudden it looms big. It gets harder and harder to actually attain that first down.
They'll begin the drive with a Ajayi. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out, and by a few inches, that'll be a first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
Stay on the ground. Again, it's Ajayi. And he'll do a nice job here just to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. Second down. Well, at least he was able to break that initial contact, or it could have been a loss.
Yeah, give credit to the defensive player, though. What did he do? Made him slow down, slow up his feet, and allowed the rest of the guys to get there to finish him off.
Ajayi, and they see right through that defensively. as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
We think, Brandon, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, but they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle. Back live with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gaudin. It's the Eagles with the ball here to begin quarter number two. They do, however, have a tough third and long coming up. Now Foles. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 45. And give him 12 yards and a first down.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
Here's Ajayi. There's the stiff arm. And he'll be brought down at the 50 after a gain of about five.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And this is Ertz with it, right side. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
First down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. Just a gain of a couple, but good enough to keep the drive rolling.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
They run again with a Jay. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. They'll set up a throw over the middle to Smith. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for 3rd down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. He lost 2, and it brings up 4th.
Partner, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen, we have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle. In anyway, but plenty of distance there as he banks it in, and that will tie us at 3-3. Well, he needed a little love from the right upright that time, but fortune smiled down on him.
Yeah, I mean, in terms of distance, he had more than enough. The only question was keeping it straight, and he's indeed very fortunate to get the bounce there.
So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So out come the Falcons now. And they had a long drive last time, but they had to settle for a field goal, and I'm sure that's how it felt to them, settling. They probably should have gotten in the end zone.
Yeah, not out now joy, right? Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone. But there are benefits to that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break, adjust a little bit, maybe get themselves ready to get back out on the field and play a little bit better. So they'll take the benefit even though they wanted the 6 points.
Yeah, maybe wore down the other defense. We'll see. Looking deep downfield. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
But one thing's for sure, when you've got a big receiver and you trust him downfield, you got to give him opportunities to go up and get that 50-50 ball.
And he is a darn good big receiver. Unfortunately, that time didn't work out. Nice job defensively. On second down, Freeman. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. He only got a couple on that one, so not a ton of help. They'll have a third and eight forthcoming.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
On third down, Ryan. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
That's a first down if he holds on, but you saw the contact, able to jar it free from him and force a fourth down.
Great play defensively there, as you said, just to knock it free, because if he had caught that, pass the sticks, first down. On fourth down, here's Matt Bosher on to punt. This is brought in at the 21. 12 yards on the return that time. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. And he'll get this up to about the 40. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and two. They'll throw. Going for the deep ball. That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Alshon Jeffrey, 60 yards. And the Eagles are able to strike quickly for six. Well, they had gone run the previous play. Nice little setup. This time they go play action. Defense bites a bit, and they hit for a big play in the end zone.
So they sold it really well, didn't they? Because of just what you described, they ran at the previous play, come back with the same action, and now they step back and throw it and get a big play for a touchdown. But what happens as a defensive back is your eyes have to go to the right place. You always hear Coach talk about, are your eyes in the right spot? Well, this time the eyes went to the play action. It froze their feet. They weren't moving, and he went on past them and caught the pass for a touchdown.
Elliott now to kick this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Even with that broken tackle, can't go very far. Stops short of the 30. A gain of 3, second down.
Doesn't matter who you're rooting for in this game, the effort of the man with the football, getting away from one and trying to turn forward and get some yardage, I really liked what he did there.
Now Ryan on second down. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
The offense on third down tonight, they've only converted once in 4 tries. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. Ryan on the handoff. It's Freeman. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks.
I think I saw a lot of shoulders just drop there. And what I mean by that is they finally were able to relax a little bit because that was an important play call. They needed to pick up that first down at this stage of the game.
Yeah, couldn't afford another quick drive and out. They go play action here on first down. And his throw is going to be incomplete. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. Well, speaking of incomplete passes, we had a very controversial incomplete pass in Week 15 in that Steelers-Patriots game, did we not?
In the city of Pittsburgh, it wasn't incomplete.
Right, yeah. For them, they won.
If
they
you're
won,
a Steelers
right?
fan, that was not an incomplete pass. That was a touchdown. But by letter of the law, having to catch a football as a receiver's going to the ground, he has to survive the ground, holding on to the football firmly. But letter of the law, wasn't a catch.
Right.
The problem is, you put 100 people in a room, it looks like a catch.
Right. So then the question going forward is, does that rule need to be changed?
Well, the competition committee tried to define it clearly 2 years ago. I think they'll be back here this spring, once again, trying to clearly define what is a catch. Because right now, a lot of people are confused.
Throwing now, Ryan on first down. And finding the tight end, Hooper. No gain there on the completion, 2nd and 10.
Pass complete, but no gain.
No yards.
Yeah.
So you file that as unsuccessful.
Yeah, you do, don't you? Except on the stats, throwing the ball.
Get a completion.
You get a catch.
Yeah.
But still,
no
yardage. Okay.
On 2nd down, Ryan hits his target. It's Taylor Gabriel. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. He got 29 yards that time.
They hit that crossing route really well. Excellent timing. Puts it right on him, and he keeps running.
Yeah, turned it upfield for good yardage. Zone now. Here's Ryan on first down. He hits his target. It's the tight end, Toilolo. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice gain right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Yeah, that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves them back 5. And it looks like this will likely be the last play before we hit the 2-minute warning. After the penalty, here's Freeman. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. He lost 2 there, and it's 3rd down. The Falcons on 3rd down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 9.
Look out! Check! Look out!
From the gun, it's Ryan. And probably the wise decision there. No one open. He just throws it away. And that keeps the field goal on the table as it's fourth down.
But that was certainly an aggressive call and an aggressive play. Instead of just going for the first down, took the shot in the end zone, went for the touchdown.
And on third down, they said, forget about the sticks. We want six. And in his 15th season, he's able to get this one to go. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in three.
It's good to be the kicker for the top offense in the NFL, and Matt Bryant was that in 2016. Led the league in scoring with 158 points, but boy, does Atlanta find him valuable. So dependable and clutch.
And he's been valuable in this league for a while. Hard to believe he's been around since 2002. Here's Bosher to kick it away. On the return, it's Kenyon Barner. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Here comes Eagle offense now as they get set to take over here. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Foles. Ertz over the middle. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one, and that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. To throw here on first down. His throw incomplete. Torrey Smith, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down. Hey, partner, I want to sidestep for a second. Week 15, Raiders Cowboys. I know you saw that crazy first down measurement. Very, very controversial.
Look, it didn't pass the eye test, and what I mean by that is when they put the ball down and brought the chains out, you couldn't just look at it and say first down or not. Balls, you know, the nose of the ball is over. I mean, you had everyone eyeing it, looking at it. It's about making sure the posts are directly at 90 degrees. Do you need a leveler out there? I mean, everything was going on in the discussion. And finally, Gene Steratore, the referee, pulls an index card out of his back pocket to slide it between the football and the marker and signals first down. Now, we haven't seen that since, what, Bill Vinovich?
Yeah.
Was that 2013?
2013.
Not an everyday occurrence,
no.
But you do what you have to do to get the job done. So anyone wants to put a computer chip in the football, this is a great time to bring that idea back.
I think Jack Del Rio might want to put a chip in the football.
No doubt.
And Jeffrey's got it. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense, as he'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. First down, he'll drop to throw. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout, as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. Second and very short here, less than a yard. He'll look to throw. They dump off underneath to Ajayi. And down inside the 15 he goes. They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
It appears they found something that's working, and they keep going back to it. I guess you can actually say he has the hot hands now, doesn't he?
Yeah, well, it's one thing to hit your guy out of the backfield once, hit him a couple times. Yeah, you're right. Maybe they're onto something.
And I think a lot of that is simply if you get it to him in space, more times than not, he's going to get more yardage than you expect out of each play.
Ertz has it left side, and he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Here's Foles. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds. Alshon Jeffrey, the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down.
You can't be precise with your throws, especially in this situation. You're inside the 10-yard line going into the end zone. But sometimes the emotion, the excitement, sometimes the decisions just aren't made very well because of that.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And they're going to get him. They bring him down to the sack back at the 16-yard line. They've been moving the ball well offensively, really getting into a groove. Last play, pass completion. Now, finally, the defense gets there.
And you have to find a way to disrupt their rhythm. Do you do it with coverage, or do you do it with pressure? They elected to go with pressure, and it was the right call.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. Andre Roberts now to return it. Oh, good footwork on the spin. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Here are the Falcons as their offense heads back onto the field. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Trying to get that in the hands of Devontae Freeman that time. And that'll bring up second down. Well, hey, with this window, two teams that we've been talking about this year that really deserve discussion and more discussion as we continue to go. How about the Rams and the Jags and the turnarounds that they've had this year?
They have been dramatic. They've been dominating at times when you look at how they played. I mean, we just saw the Rams, it was a week 15, went to Seattle and decimated the Seahawks to really take over the NFC West. The Jaguars have steadily gotten better throughout the season. I mean, in preseason, the Rams weren't thought of as a team that would make this dramatic a turnaround. Jaguars, they were kind of that trendy, could they be, but they have been for a number of years. This has been something else, and my hat is off to both of these organizations.
On third down, Ryan. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
And we're into the second half now. This is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. Here's Matt Bosher now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And this will be taken at the 13. Call that one an even 60 yards. 6-0. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen,
Let's take control right away. Defense.
We got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see if the offense gets done.
Second down following the run. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Caught by the tight end, Ertz. And he's able to get up here to the 26. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
The Eagles on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. This is Ajayi. Ajayi hit. He lost the football. And the Falcons grab it. And to the 43. So down inside the 45 to the 43-yard line. That's where they'll take over. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about 6.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between 2nd and 4 and 2nd and 8 and 9.
See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. They'll run it now out of the gun. Give him a yard on the run there, and that's going to set up a 3rd down and 2.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it, because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
The Eagles on 3rd down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. Here it's 3rd and 2. He'll drop to throw, and incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down.
Perhaps they overthought this one a little bit. They've been running it real well on this drive, and it was 3rd and short, okay? They decided to throw the football incomplete. Yeah, they might have thought just a little bit too hard about that play selection.
Here's Donnie Jones now as he's on to punt for Philadelphia. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. And that'll hit at the 5 and go into the end zone for a touchback. Atlanta now coming out on the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack, because most of the yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that, because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another 1st down with that run.
On 1st and 10, it's Ryan. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. Now a play fake here on 1st down. And he 0 first shot in there. It's out of bounds, incomplete. Austin Hooper, the tight end, was the intended target. And it's second down. Well, hey, in the spirit of the holidays, let's have some fun. You sent out something on social media last week I thought was great. You asked it, if Santa Claus was in the NFL, what position would he be playing?
Well, we got some great responses, on that one.
What was the theme?
A lot of people looked at him as a defender. Zero technique, which would be a nose guard, right, because of his...
Blitz coming, and down he goes. Nigel Bradham coming on the blitz. He gets him for a loss of 7.
Partner, I know the ball security's preached like crazy, but every now and then you've got to know when to get rid of the football and save a little bit of yardage if you're a quarterback.
Because now if you're the offensive coordinator, what does it do if it was 3rd and 10 versus 3rd and much longer as it is now?
Yeah, it changes everything in terms of play calling and the pressure you might expect to face on the very next down. Had to throw the ball away and save the yardage. He didn't get it done.
And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up 4th down. A pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
They'll start out on the ground with the Giants. Fights forward for only about a yard up to the 21.
Nice job by the defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. And after the play on the ground, that brings up 2nd down here. Play fake. He'll look to throw. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Grady Jarrett with a great push up front. He picks up the sack and a loss of 8. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result?
Sack.
Quarterback gets hit.
The Eagles on 3rd down. They've converted 3 times and 8 chances. This is 3rd and 17. Now Foles. Looking deep for his tight end, Ertz. And a shot taken on 3rd down, unsuccessful. 4th down now.
Well, he bounced up after taking a sack and took a shot downfield. I think a lot of us thought maybe he'd run draw in that situation instead. Tried to get all back in one play.
Yeah, 3rd and long, thought he needed the deep pass, couldn't connect it.
Maybe he was hoping for a penalty downfield to give him the yardage they needed.
He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. And a fair catch taken here right at about the 40-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And out will come the offense as they take over. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back to some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. Well, that incompletion there gives us a chance to inform the Madden community that we are taking a little bit of a break for the holidays.
A brief hiatus.
And the next live content update, next commentary update will be coming January 10th.
Well, that just means if we're coming back for January 10th, we're talking playoffs.
We will be talking playoffs.
We'll be talking the meat of the action, the best part of the season, the gift that keeps on giving. All right, so the post-Christmas blues will be over because we'll be talking about the playoffs. real easy to say this running game needs to be better, but the reality is they've been given little time to actually find a place to run the football. It's almost like the defense is there on the handoff.
The Falcons on third down. They've struggled to the tune of 2 for 8 so far. This is third and 11. From the shotgun, Ryan. It's caught, Jones. Touchdown, Falcons. Julio Jones, 61 yards. And the Falcons are in for 6. Well, they had their chances in the first half, you remember, but had to settle for 2 field goals. This time they come away with 6.
I think they actually got affirmation about what they were doing by getting a touchdown, because the field goals means they got in range but couldn't quite finish it off. This time, they broke through, and that's great for the old confidence.
And on the sideline, difference of a feeling between 3 and 6, is it astronomical or no?
It can be at times, that's for sure. A lot of times, the field goal feels like a disappointment. The touchdown, well, that tells you you're getting it done.
Here's Bosher to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. Now Philadelphia ready to get going on offense again. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
They'll look to throw here. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. They'll drop to throw. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Smith. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks.
Timing is everything, and they work on this cut all the time. They work on all the timing patterns, and this time it paid off for them. Worked him to the center of the field, cut it to the outside, ball's delivered, gets both feet down for the completion.
Welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. They'll look to throw now on first down. Drops it off to Ajayi. And a nice little quick spin move before he's dropped. And a pretty good game. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there. If he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw.
They'll wind up losing 3 yards here, and they're going to have a third down. They'll look to throw. Jeffrey with a catch left side. 17 yards is the pickup there for number 17. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
First down. He'll drop to throw it. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. He was trying to get it to Zach Ertz that time. And now it's second down.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past, the biggest teaching point. Get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
To throw now on second and 10. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Nelson Agholor, the intended receiver, and it's third down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. To throw here, finding his safety valve here. That's complete. It'll be a gain of 6, and that's going to make it fourth down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways. All right, you don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything. And sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
Well, you talk about clutch right down the pipe, and this game's all even here in the fourth.
And he didn't leave much doubt there, did he? Good snap, good hold, and that one was dead center.
So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. Fielded about a yard deep. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Throwing now, Ryan on first down. And it's caught over the middle, Hooper. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
It's vitally important to wrap him up immediately, because if you let that big guy get ahead of steam up, boy, then you've got real trouble trying to get him down.
But they're able to hold him to a short gain on first down. On second down, Ryan. And this is Gabriel on the catch. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. The Falcons on third down. They've converted a third of their opportunities, 3 for 9. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. Ryan now off the bootleg. And yes, he found Toilolo. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. Ryan to Toilolo for the Falcon first.
They brought in a heavy set on third down, and that usually means running play, but we have seen them throw out of that formation, and sure enough, they snuck the tight end out on that one, wound up hitting him for a first down.
They go play action here on first down. Sanu with a grab over the middle, and he's brought down. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-arm guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Off the play fake to Freeman. It's Ryan. Wow. wide open receiver complete. And out of bounds all the way down at the 2-yard line. That one goes for 36 yards. It's been all passing all the time on this drive. 5 for 5, and now first and goal.
Feels like a case of, until they stop us, we might as well keep running the offense that we like to run. Don't change up and do something different just because you think you need to.
They'll look to run with Freeman. And this is not going to do it as he stopped at the 2-yard line. No gain there, and it's going to set up second and goal.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get him in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
Well, again, it'll be Freeman. That is not going to be any help as they dump it behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And that is going to set up third and goal. And the offense can string something together, but they'll need to do it quickly here to try to get points on the board and win this game. On third and goal, Ryan. And probably the wise decision there. No one open. He just throws it away. And that keeps the field goal on the table as it's fourth down.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of. Otherwise, he was going to get sacked.
So an important try here from Matt Bryant. This to break our fourth quarter tie. And Bryant's kick is good. And with that, they will move out in front by 3. So the drive here ends with a field goal, and that does give them the lead, but this one is still a long ways from over.
And you love to be able to look up at the scoreboard and see that you're out in front, but then you take one look across the field and see that offense is raring to come back out, and you think, I don't know that field goals are going to be enough to get us home.
Here's Bosher to kick it away. This one fielded at the 5. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. The Eagles coming out as they get ready. And after the field goal last time, let's see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you've met fan bases that wanted that. They weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick other than the extra point. That's it.
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
And, Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensive.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. Nigel Bradham in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon. Going to give it to Freeman, and he's going to be stopped up at about the 47-yard line. And now right out of the 2-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go.
Three.
And some secondary help here for the defense and the nickel on third and long. Coleman. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause in the action. A timeout here defensively. Here's Matt Bosher now. He's been terrific so far. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. He'll look to throw. And he can't hang on to it. That one is sealed in. Instead, second down. He was unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
Back to throw. That ball's caught. Aguilar, right side. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game. Adrian Claiborne in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. He's back to throw. And he can't corral it. That would have wrapped it up if he'd been able to hold on. Instead, it brings up third down. Back-to-back big plays defensively. First the sack. Now they force the incompletion on third and long. Things looking pretty good for them.
And this is where they have to be careful, because they've got the momentum going their way. They will be really amped up to get to the quarterback. Look out. Draw, screen, something that can be used against them.
They'll look to throw. And this is Ertz with it, right side. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down. Back to throw. And that is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Falcons are close to finishing off this football game. Well, certainly not the way that they were hoping that possession would end, failing to convert on fourth.
And now they've got to make sure that they keep their poise, they keep their confidence. Just because it didn't work once doesn't mean if they get that same situation later that they shouldn't go for it again. The defense feels great, but the offense, they can't be despondent.
The Falcons in victory formation as they take an aim. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. The Falcons in victory formation as they take an aim. Ryan heads down to a knee, and that should wrap this one up. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you prime the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. Check us out at EASports.com. With that, we say so long from